Hello everyone, and welcome back to Wheelabout's Tutorial Zoo Workshop. I'm Wheelabout. On today's episode, we're going to be focusing on the Habitat Planning Guide. The first step to building any habitat is making sure that we have the staff area to support it. We're going to build a staff area right back here, as we'll probably be building our habitat somewhere in this area. Let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so this is the staff area that we came up with. It's not the best. I'll probably be doing some tweaking off camera. But I wanted you guys to get an idea of how you can take a blueprint and just copy it to cover up the rest of the buildings that you want in that area. That way you have them match a little bit more, a little bit more coherent. the next step in the process is we're going to be building that habitat. I left this little notch right here. The habitat's probably going to be somewhere out here, and we'll have to extend the main path. So let's go ahead and get into it. Alright, so the terraforming is done. I created this small little keeper's entrance here I know some people don't like it to look messy in here. So this is something that you could do just to keep it looking neat, and still looking a little bit real. That way you don't have just tunnels. And then we're gonna layer this with rocks so it looks a little bit more natural. But we've also got a little shelter in here, and this will be our stable. We'll clear this up in a second. And we're gonna layer this up with rocks as well, so this will be the entrance to it. I wanted to have these soft hills because we're gonna be adding some llamas in here. Gonna be doing a double fence instead of a dip. I generally try to do that with some of the domesticated animals or some of the other hoofed animals. I'll just do a double fence and I'll show you guys what that kind of looks like. But yeah, let's go ahead and put some rocks in there and see how that turns out. Alright, so the rocks are done. A couple other things before I keep going with the plants and a few more decorations. I wanted to talk about this area that I cut off in the back. I made this sharp cutoff so that we could keep the rolling hills, but also keep the llamas inside. They shouldn't be able to jump this high. We might have to lower it a little bit or make it a little steeper. And we could add some rocks and some plants to hide it when you're seeing it from this direction. So we'll work on making that look a little bit nicer. Now, as far as the rocks go, you want to make sure that you're rotating each rock between placement. That will give it a little bit more of a varied look. Let's keep going with the trees and the decorations. Alright, so the trees are done. I decided to go with the Pampas Grasslands plant palette for this one. I'll put a link to the palette in the description of this video. One thing I like to do with my trees is I like to sink them into the background. I feel like this helps add a little bit more depth. I also put this temple on the hilltop. I have it in my sandbox and I really like how it looks. Let's keep adding some more plants. Now that the plants are done, the next step would usually be terrain paint. But because I want to keep this grassy for the llamas, we're going to move straight to detailing. Let's go ahead and fix this up a bit. Alrighty, folks, and the detailing is done. We still have a few more things to do, like lighting, benches, education boards, and we'll get to those. But I wanted to talk a little bit about this rock placement right over here. We switched from mossy rocks to temperate rocks. And we did that by just blending the rocks together and then throwing some plants on top. It helps camouflage that seam a little better. Now these fences, I did get them off of the workshop. You could find a lot of different type of fences if you search fences on the Steam Workshop. These are the ones that I found, and I just went through them, and those are the ones that I picked. So let's finish up this area with a little bit more detailing and get it all wrapped up. Now that this is done, let's go ahead and finish up the barrier and get our llamas in here. The llamas are in. One thing that I always like to do when I first put in an animal into the habitat is I like to go to the heat maps and check the traversable area. If That way you could see where they could escape from and place rocks while in that view to block them. We ended up having to put these rocks here to keep the llamas from escaping. That's going to do it for today's episode. On the next episode, we'll be building another habitat and doing a lot more detailing on this side. We'll also possibly be starting a transport ride. We're going to finish it up with some shots of the llamas, but I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Thanks so much for watching.